Hey guys, welcome to Coding and Flow. In this video series, we will learn the Kotlin programming language from scratch. This course is suited for beginners that have no programming experience whatsoever, but of course you can also follow along if you already know other programming languages. Considering that many people who want to learn Kotlin already have a Java background, I will draw some comparisons between the two languages here and there whenever I see fit. This way, everyone who already knows Java will better understand how both languages relate, and everyone without Java knowledge will get an idea on what Kotlin is doing better than Java and what we had to struggle with in the past. But again, you can watch this tutorial without any programming experience whatsoever. Usually, I create Android tutorials in Java on this channel, and while Kotlin currently plays its biggest role on Android, I want to keep this course disconnected from Android development. This means we will not learn how to build Android apps here. Instead, we will focus on the Kotlin language directly. However, what you learn here is also directly applicable to Android development. In the next video, we will install IntelliJ IDEA together. That's the software where we will write code in. If you want to use Android Studio instead, then you can do that as well, but you will have to make some adaptations here and there. But before we download IntelliJ, let's start with a little bit of history, so we know what we are dealing with here and what reasons we have to learn this language. So Kotlin is a relatively newer programming language. It was first announced in 2011, and version 1.0 was only released in 2016. Java, in comparison, is 20 years older than that. And the reason why I compared to Java this whole time is because Kotlin was basically designed as a better and more modern version of Java. It improves upon a lot of the pain points and bad design decisions in the Java language that turned out to be the most annoying over the last more than 20 years. This doesn't mean Java is obsolete. In fact, it's still one of the most widely used languages up to this date, and it won't disappear anytime soon, but the developers had a lot of time to learn what could be done better. A very popular example that you might have already heard of is how both languages handle so-called null values. In Java, a variable can be null, which, in a very simplified view, means that it doesn't contain anything. Something that doesn't exist can't perform an operation. Makes sense. So before you can tell this variable to do something, you have to put an object in there that knows how to do that operation. But in Java, it is possible that you skip this first step, especially when your code is more complex. And when you try to let a non-existing thing perform an operation, you get into an impossible scenario where the program doesn't know what to do. And when that happens, it has no other option than to shut down. And this is what we experience as a crash. In this case, caused by a so-called null pointer exception. And the big problem is that errors like this happen when the application is already in use, when it's very critical that it works. In fact, this has caused so much financial damage over time that the inventor of the null reference even calls it his billion-dollar mistake, which is probably still an understatement. In Kotlin, null still exists, but the language is designed in a way that it detects wrong handling of these null values already at compile time. This means you have to fix them before you can even run the program. This makes it almost impossible to get into a scenario where a variable that is null would try to perform an action, and this in turn leads to more stable applications. But this is just one of many of Kotlin's language features. There are many more that make the code more concise, more readable and more robust, and we will learn about many of them in the upcoming parts. So don't forget to subscribe to the channel to not miss that. Okay, but even if a language is better than another one, that doesn't automatically mean that it also becomes very popular. Especially large companies are usually very reluctant when it comes to adopting a new language, because it means investing time and money into something that hasn't been battle-tested yet, that hasn't as many tools available, and that could potentially disappear again soon. And rewriting a large codebase into a new language is of course an enormous task, and usually not worth the effort. The reason why Kotlin became so popular in the last years is because it was announced as an officially supported language for native Android development at the Google I/O 2017.
We have never added a new programming language to Android, and today we're making Kotlin an officially supported language in Android.
And in 2019, just recently, Google even announced that Android will from now on be Kotlin first, which basically means that Android programming will be optimized for the Kotlin language, harnessing the language-specific features, and also code samples and online training will be available in Kotlin rather than in Java. However, Java is still a completely valid and fully supported language for Android development. Another very important point that drives the adoption of Kotlin is the fact that it is completely interoperable with Java. You can call Java code from Kotlin and vice versa. This means developers don't have to convert their whole existing codebase to Kotlin at once, but instead they can add new Kotlin code bit by bit to an already existing Java project and rewrite small parts whenever it is convenient. This is possible because Kotlin and Java ultimately get turned into the same so-called Java bytecode, which is sort of an intermediate step before the code gets turned into something that the computer can actually understand. In fact, you can even compile Kotlin code into this bytecode and then convert it back into its corresponding Java representation. Just that this Java code then usually has to do a lot of workarounds to mimic the same behavior as the Kotlin equivalent. By turning it into this Java bytecode, Kotlin can be used anywhere Java is used, like on Android devices, on desktops or web servers, and it can also use the existing Java tools there. But not only that, instead of compiling it to Java bytecode, it is also possible to compile Kotlin code to JavaScript to run it in a web browser. Or it can skip these intermediate steps completely and target particular operating systems directly, which makes it possible to run Kotlin code virtually everywhere, including for example iOS. This is what we refer to as Kotlin native. In this tutorial we will use the first variation, the one that is Java interoperable, because it's the most widely used and the most stable at this point. However, the basic syntax of these different compilation targets is the same, so you can watch this tutorial even if you plan to compile to JavaScript or native binaries. Okay, in the next part we will set up IntelliJ IDE on our computer and then start learning the language. So don't forget to subscribe to not miss any upcoming parts. Take care.